Hi everyone, in this tutorial we are going to talk about how to use clipping masks to insert a piece into your image. So this image has started off with a regular image here, which is a background that I have made invisible by clicking on the invisible key here, the eyeball, and it's also locked, and this is to preserve my original image. Here's the new image, here's an adjustment layer changing the levels to make it not so washed out from the scan, and here's a hue and saturation to change the color. You can see there's a little mask here that has allowed this one little thought bubble where the Oil of Olay body wash is thinking about another body wash, that this is allowed it to preserve the original color. What I want to do here is replace this Oil of Olay bottle with a picture of an old woman because it's an anti-aging cream. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to open up Chrome or any other browser. And what I've done is gone to Google Images and I searched for just old woman. And you can see there's a bunch here, but what I wanted to point out is that I clicked on large in this size. And it's really important to have the right size resolution because you have to make it fit in your new image. So once you click on this image, you right click or option click on full size, and then you save the link as. In the Mac or in the PC, it might put it in some weird place, maybe a downloads folder. So you need to be aware that it's going to do that just in case so that you can move it someplace else if you choose to. So once this is done, you can see here I've got this image down here, the icon where I've saved it, and I'm going to drag it into Photoshop. What I'm not going to do is just drop it on this image here. I'm either going to drop it on the Photoshop icon, which is at the bottom of your screen, especially for a Mac, that's what you're going to do. Or you can drop it somewhere up here if you're using a PC to make sure that it opens as a separate file in Photoshop. You can also just go to File and Open. Once this is open, it should open in a separate tab. And when we're here, we can then grab our background layer and put it onto our other image. So to do that, you have to make this tab a separate little window here so that you've got the other one exposed, and you just drag it on top. And that's what you should have, one tab with this image here, but it should be as a separate layer, and that's very, very important. So once this is a separate layer, we need to be able to edit it. Especially we need to be able to cut her head out of this space. So the first thing you're going to do there is to make this a smart object. And the reason you're doing that is because you want to preserve this layer as it is, and you want to be able to resize it without distorting it at all. So you can just go to Edit Transform and transform the scale, but you really want to be able to play with it without destroying the original quality of the image. So what I'm going to do is either right-click, option-click here, and change it that way, or go to Layer, Smart Object, Convert to Smart Object. So once it's a smart object, it basically has this little icon here, and then you should double-click on it. When you double click, it's going to bring up this dialog box, which is going to tell you that you need to save any changes you make, and it would open it as a new layer. Basically, this is like converting a Photoshop image into a layer. So this now becomes a separate Photoshop image where you can have multiple layers, etc. And that's exactly what we're going to do here. The first thing that we need to do is actually select everything around her face. And the way to do that is there's two ways. You can use Quick Mask and you can paint her face, which would make it deselected, make it selected. Or you can use Quick Select or anything like that. We're going to use a combination. So what I'm going to do here is go to my Quick Selection, and I'm going to start selecting out pieces of this this piece. And you can see that it's not quite doing a perfect job here. It's getting a lot of the right areas, but especially up by the blue, we are missing some chunks of her head, and we don't want that. So once this is done, I'm actually going to hold down Alt to subtract it out, and I'm going to remove bits of her face from this selection. And I could do this all the way, but I'm not really going to worry about it. This was just to get me a little bit closer. Once I do that, I can go to my Quick Mask, which is this little icon here. And you can see her face is pink. And it's actually painted in black, just so you know, this should be black. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to zoom in really tightly and I'm going to go ahead and either erase or add bits in with black. So I've got a pretty small brush here. It's not completely hard so that there's a little bit of a fuzzy edge, which is what I want. And I'm going to go through and I'm going to paint things in great detail. Normally, you would want to do this very, very tightly to be able to get the best possible aspect here. You want to really get every little piece. In this case, because this is just a tutorial, I'm not actually using this for a professional document of my own, I'm going to do kind of a hack job. So I'm going to finish this and then we'll come back into the tutorial. Okay, so here you can see that I have finished going through this this woman, and I've come pretty close along the edges. I've left little bits here because they aren't really necessary and I didn't have time to go through it too deeply. So I'm going to right-click, option-click, click on Fit on Screen to zoom out, and you can see that her face has been all colored in. Quick Mesh just allows you to really see what you're doing in a way that regular selections don't. So I'm going to take this off, and you'll see that everything but her head is selected here. So all of this is selected, as you can see the little marching ants all the way around. So what I'm going to do here, I could just press Delete, right? And that would delete all that stuff out, and yay, we're left with her head. But what happens if I want to get some of that back, which you often do? So what I'm going to do there is undo it, and I'm going to select the inverse. And that will give me just her head. Then what I'm going to do is go to Layer, New, Layer via Copy. And what that does is it creates a new layer with just her head here. Now, there's still kind of a problem, because if I make this invisible, I've still got this area here, and you might want to do this in your main image, so I don't actually want to have it end up like this. It does work. I can just save this, so go to File, Save, and you'll see that in my original ad, it has cut out her head. Now, if you had this in your original piece, however, you might want to remove part of it out without making it into a smart object. And that's actually really easy. All you do is you drag this below it, make them both visible, and you make this into a clipping mask. So I'm going to go to Layer, Create Clipping Mask. And basically what that does is it tells you that from this image, the only piece we want to keep is whatever's here. And that could be the image itself, but it could also be something that's just painted in black or white or whatever, anything that's not transparent. So if I want to bring in part of this image, all I have to do is paint in this mask. So you can see I can bring little bits of it in and out, which is very, very useful. Let's say if you've got a cereal bowl where there's a bunch of cereal around or something like that, where you've got lots of little bits and pieces, often you want to use a clipping mask instead of doing a layer via copy. It just makes it much, much easier, and it's much easier to edit it later on. Masks just simplify things a lot. So I'm going to go ahead and keep this. So I'm going to save it. As opposed to just doing this layer and making this one invisible, I'm going to save it as a clipping mask, and I'm going to go back into my original ad. When I'm here, all I have to do is resize it, in which case I just go to Edit, Transform, and Scale. And I can do distortions and all of those kinds of things, but in this case I'm going to press Shift to keep the aspect ratio the same. So I'm going to make it about that size. Looks like that's a little big. So I'm going to make it a little smaller, and voila, it fits. I'm going to press Enter to accept the transformation. I could press Escape to cancel it. And it's good. All I have to do is take out this little Oil Volet bottle and maybe mess with the way it looks to make it integrate a little bit better into the advertisement, and I'm good to go. That's it.